So last class we started with the event. So we have discussed that the sample space will be having all possible outcomes of an experiment. Okay, and the sample space is also called, or what we call it as, it is a universal set for that particular experiment. Okay, so event is subset of the sample space, and it collects outcomes of particular interest. So for example, I am interested with getting the even head when we are throwing a die. Okay, so the set will be consisting of particular interest, and probability of an event we denote it as P of A. Say for example, A is the event. How do we denote the probability of an event? As P of A. Okay, and it is obtained by summing the probabilities of outcomes contained within a event A. Okay, so for example, our event is getting an even number when we throw a die. So A will have the values 2, 4, 6. Okay, and what is the probability of getting A will be, what is the probability of individual outcomes in that particular event? Okay, so what is the probability of 2 is 1/6, probability of 4 is 1/6, and probability of 6 is also 1/6. So we'll be adding all the three, so that probability of getting an even number when we throw a die will be 3/6, that is equal to 1/2. Okay, so event is said to occur if one of the outcome contained with the event occurs. Okay, for example, our event, what is our event here, is getting even number when we throw a die. Okay, so when we say that the event is occurred when we get at least 2 or 4 or 8, any of these three, any one of that is occurring, then we say that the event is occurred. Okay, so next we'll discuss what is complement. Okay, so this is about probability. Okay, then probability of event is, this we have discussed already, the probability of event is sum of the probabilities of simple events that constitutes the event. Here in this case, what is the probability of getting an even number? Just now we have discussed that it is equal to 1/2. So here we will be finding what is the probability of getting 2 plus probability of getting 4 plus probability of getting 6. So that what is the probability of getting an even number will be equal to sum of probabilities of individual outcome in that particular event. So that it will be equal to 1/2. Okay. So this also we have discussed in the last class. So here, see this. Here we have taken a sample space which consists of 8 outcomes. Okay. So what is the probability of A will be, what are all the elements or what are the outcomes are present in A? So there are 3 outcomes in present A. What is the probability of A will be, sum of the probabilities of each outcome? So that what is the probability of A will be equal to 0.55. okay, and probability of A complement. So now we should not consider whatever elements present in A, so other than the elements present in A will be considered here. So the A complement will have the elements which are present in S other than A. So we have 5 elements. Okay, so if you add this probability, we got 0.45. okay, so you know that what is the probability of sample space? The probability of sample space is equal to 1. So the sample space can also be written like this. It is the probability of A plus probability of A complement. This will give us what is the probability of sample space. So it is equal to 1. Okay, and what is complement? The complement and the event A complement is nothing but the event consisting of everything in the sample space that is not contained with the element A. Okay, so you should not consider whatever elements or whatever outcomes are there in A. Other than that, whatever elements present in the sample space, all that will come under A complement. Okay, so P of A plus P of A complement is equal to 1. So the event that consists of individual outcomes are sometimes referred to as elementary events or simple events. So for example, if you take getting an even number when we throw a die, what are the outcomes we have in that particular event will be 2, 4, 6. Okay, so in that case, so individual outcome, what we call it as Individual outcome, we call it as elementary events or simple events. Okay. Individual outcomes, we call it as elementary events or simple events. Similarly, this is the example we have discussed in the last class. Okay. Say here we have probability of A. Sorry, we have what is set A. Set A will have three errors. So, 0 error, 1 error, 2 error. Okay. This is subset of sample space capital S. Now, what is the probability of set A will be? For example, what is the probability of 0 errors, probability of 1 error, probability of 2 errors will be 0.05 plus 0.08 plus 0.35 is equal to 0.48. Okay. Now, what is the probability of A complement will be equal to 1 minus P of A. Okay, that is equal to 1 minus 0.48. Okay, so that A complement will be equal to 0.52. In the previous case, we have seen that probability of A plus probability of A complement is equal to 1. No? So from that, what is probability of A complement is equal to 1 minus P of A. So it is equal to 1 minus 0.48. That is equal to 0.52. Okay. So this also we have discussed in the last class. Here we see that there are the events and complements of events. Okay. So when here, what is that we are doing? We are throwing a die, single die. So what is the event here? Event here is getting an even score when we throw a die. Okay. So even values are 2, 4, 6. Okay. Now, what is the probability of even getting an even number is equal to 1 by 2. So, what is that we'll be doing? We'll be adding the probability of each individual element. So, what is the single individual elements are called? Elementary elements, or what is that we call it as? Elementary elements or simple events. Elementary events or simple events. The individual outcome is called elementary event or simple event. Okay. So, then, for example, when we throw a die, what is the probability here is? Probability of getting the sum of the score on two dice is equal to 6. Okay. For this, what you have to do? So, for this, first we have to write what is this sample space. Okay. See the sample space, all of you. See the sample space. The sample space is having the values 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 3. So, the first value belongs to first die, second value belongs to second die. So, what are the possible combinations we will be getting here is 36 combinations. Okay. So, it is unbiased die. So, that the what is the probability of each and every element in this sample space is having the probability of 1 by 36. Okay. So, each element will be having what is the probability here? 1 by 36, because it is unbiased by each element will have identical probability, same probability. Okay. So here, what is the probability of getting the sum is equal to 6? Now you check it. Which are the cases, in which cases we get sum is equal to 6? If you check that, we can find out that. So there is a case 1, 5. First die is having value 1. Whereas second die will be having value 5. Okay. 2, 4, 3, 3, 4, 2, and 5, 1. Okay. These are the different possibilities where we get sum is equal to 6. Okay. Now, what is the probability of getting the sum is equal to 6 will be sum of all the probability of each outcome in this event. So we'll be adding 1 by 36 plus 1 by 36 plus 1 by 36 plus 1 by 36 plus 1 by 36. It is equal to 5 by 36. Okay. So what is the probability of getting the sum is equal to 6 is equal to what is the probability here? It is 5 by 36. 5 by 36 is the probability that the sum is equal to 6. Okay. So this also we have discussed in the last class. And see here, what is the probability that, here the event B will be, is that at least one of two dice records a value 6. Okay, when you throw two dice, at least one of the dice should have the value 6. What is the probability in this case here is, to see this, we have to write this number of events once again. and check what are the possible cases we have to get the value is equal to 6 for any one of the type. Okay, this last row and last column will have all possible cases. So if you count number of elements in this B, number of elements in this event B, so here we have 11 elements. So the total elements is equal to 36. Okay. So what is the probability of B will be equal to 11 by 36. So what is the probability of B complement? So we have discussed that probability of B plus probability of B complement is equal to 1. So that probability of B complement is equal to 1 minus probability of B. So that is equal to 25 by 36. This one. Is it clear, students? Any doubts here? Okay. So this we have discussed in the last class. And we also discussed what are the different types of events. Okay. So we call exhaustive event is the first case. Here, the set of events is said to be exhaustive if it includes all possible events. Okay. So then it is called exhaustive event. So if you take any particular experiment, okay, so all possible outcomes are included in particular event, then we call it as exhaustive event. Okay. So in this case, for example, if you throw a die, so this exhaustive event will have the values 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. All the possible outcomes for what is the when we throw a die. So all that will present in that particular event, then it is called exhaustive event. Okay. And mutually exclusive event. Okay. Two events, A and B, are said to be mutually exclusive if they cannot occur together. So if these two events does not occur together, then these two events are called mutually exclusive events. Okay. So if that is what, say for example, if you take mutually exclusive events, what is A union B will be equal to probability of A plus probability of B, because probability of A intersection B is equal to null set. What is probability of A intersection B will be equal to null set or empty set. That is why for mutually exclusive events, probability of A union B will be equal to probability of A plus probability of B. So here, those two events does not occur together. For example, when we throw a die, the event A will be getting an even number, and the event B will be getting odd number. Okay. So the event A will be having the values 2, 4, 6. Whereas event B will be having the values 1, 3, 5. Okay. So these two events does not occur together. Okay. So that is why these two are called mutually exclusive events. For mutually exclusive events, P of A union B will be equal to P of A plus P of B. Okay. So this is about mutually exclusive events and equally likely events. If one of the events cannot be expected to happen in reference to the another, then such events are said to be equally likely events. Each outcome of random experiments has an equal chance of occurrence. Okay. So for example, when we throw a die, okay, we may get head or tail. So these are equally likely events. Okay. And similarly means that each outcome in that particular event will be having the same probability. Okay. For example, when we throw a die. So when we throw a die, what are the possible outcomes we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yes or no? So what is the probability of each outcome will be equal to 1 by 6? We may get any of this as output. Yes or no? So that is why these are called equally likely event. We may get any of this as output, so that these are called equally likely event. And probability of equally likely events will be identical. Okay. And similarly, independent event. Two events are said to be independent if happening or failure of one does not affect the happening or failure of other. Otherwise, the events are said to be dependent. Okay. So when one is occurring, that should not depend upon occurrence of other, then we say that these events are independent events. Okay. If the events are independent, then there is a joint probability. It is given as P intersection B. For independent events, what is joint probability? P intersection B is given as probability of A, probability of B. Okay, and we have non-mutually exclusive event. If the events are non-mutually exclusive, what is mutually exclusive? The occurrence of both the events is not possible. So then those events are called mutually exclusive. So mutually exclusive events, what is probability of A intersection B? What is probability of A intersection B for mutually exclusive events? Students, you please answer no. What is probability of A intersection B for mutually exclusive?
Zero. Zero.
It will be zero. Thank you. It will be equal to zero. So for that is why for mutually exclusive events, okay, P of A union B is given as P of A plus P of B minus P of A intersection B. Okay, so now sir, for non-mutually exclusive, for mutually exclusive, P of A intersection B will be zero. That is why for mutually exclusive events, in the previous case, you can see that P of A union B, that is probability of A union B, is given as probability of A plus probability of B. Whereas for non-mutually exclusive, since there is a common occurrence of both the events, so probability of A union B is given as probability of A plus probability of B minus probability of A intersection B. Okay, these are the five types of events. What are those? The first one is exhaustive event, mutually exclusive event, okay, equally likely event, independent events, non-mutually exclusive events. There are five types of the events. Okay, this is very important questions. This is usually asked in most of the question papers. Okay, there are five types of events. Okay, so these events are discussed in these two slides. Okay, so next we'll discuss what are the axioms of probability. Okay, so we have discussed that probabilities can be defined in two ways. Probability can be defined by using sets and axioms, and it is also defined by using relative frequency. There are two ways to represent probability. We can use sets and axioms to represent, that is one way. The other way to represent the probability is by using relative frequency. So in all these previous topics, we have discussed how to define probability using relative frequency. Okay, now we will discuss how to define the probability by using axioms. Okay, so for example, if you take any event, okay, event A, so we'll be assigning the probability to that event P of A. P of A is called probability of that event. Okay, so this particular probability of particular event should satisfy following axioms. Okay, so what is the first axiom? The first axiom is given as probability of A should be greater than or equal to zero. So till now we were discussing that what is that probability of any particular outcome in the experiment should be non-negative number, yes or no? So that is why that indicates the first axiom. First axiom indicates that probability of A should be greater than or equal to zero. Means that probability should be non-negative number. You should not have negative number for probability. That is why whenever we find out probability, the probability value will be varying from 0 to 1. Okay, it is non-negative number. It is having the values from 0 to 1. Okay, so the second axiom says that the sample space itself is an event. Okay, so itself is an event. So it is all, it will be having all the outcomes of an experiment. So it should have highest possible probability, which is selected as unity. Okay, so when you take sample space, what is here? Ohm indicates the sample space. Okay, we can use capital S or ohm to represent the sample space, whereas in this case we have used ohm to represent the sample space. What is this indicates? Okay, the event can also have the sample space can also be represented as an event. Okay, what is sample space? It will be having the outcomes of all possible outcomes of a particular experiment. Okay, so what is the probability of that particular event will be it will be having highest probability. What is highest probability? The probability value will be varying from 0 to 1, so that the highest probability will be 1. Okay. So for this reason, S is also known as certain event. Okay. It is definitely going to happen. When it is having probability 1, what does that indicate? It is definitely going to happen. There is no doubt, it is definitely going to happen. Okay. So it is having highest probability. So S is also known as certain event. What is certain event? It will be having all possible outcomes of particular experiment, so that the probability of that event means that probability of S is equal to 1, so that it will be having highest probability. So S is also known as certain event. Okay. So and what is this null set? Null set, for example, you take null set phi. Phi is a set with no elements, yes or no? So it is known as impossible event. So it is, its probability is 0. Okay. So when the event is said to be impossible, what is that? It is, it will never occur. When you say the event is impossible, it will never occur, then we say that it is impossible event and its probability will be 0. Okay. So for example, when you write an exam, if you have more confident that you will pass the exam, what is the probability that you will pass the exam will be certain, means that it is having highest probability. So when you write the exam very worst and you think that you will never pass the exam, in that case, what is that probability that you will pass the exam? Will be 0, because it is impossible to pass the exam, so that what is the probability will be 0. Okay. So that is why certain means it is going to happen definitely. Impossible means it will never happen. For certain events, the probability will be 1. For impossible events, the probability will be 0. Okay, my students? Students, what is the probability for impossible events? What is 0. The probability for impossible events will be 0. Thank you, ma'am. What is the probability for certain event? What is the probability for certain event?
1.
1 now, very good. Okay. Others, are you listening? I request all of you should listen to the class and you have to answer me. Okay. So, there is a third axiom. Okay, these are the two axioms with which we have defined. What is first axiom says? The first axiom says that the probability of any particular event is non-negative number. Okay. The second axiom says that the probability of certain event means it is having highest probability, it is having all possible outcomes, then that probability, that event probability will be equal to 1. Okay. The third axiom says that if two events are mutually exclusive, we have discussed what are the events, you know, when the two events are mutually exclusive, the occurrence of these two events together does not possible. Okay. So these two events does not occur together, that then these two events are called mutually exclusive. If the events are mutually exclusive, what happens here? A intersection B is equal to null set. So it does not have any element. Okay. Then what is the probability of A union B? A union B can be written as probability of A plus probability of B. Okay. So that is the probability of their union is sum of their probabilities. You see here the note is given, the probability of their union is sum of their probabilities. Okay. So then this is called the third axiom. Okay. So if you take the probability, axioms of probability, if you take any, what is that, identity, all those identity will satisfy these conditions. Okay. And we can prove those identities using these three axioms. Okay. So that is why these three axioms are very important. Okay. So what is that? P of A should be greater than or equal to 0, and probability of sample space is equal to 1. If two sets are mutually exclusive, what is the probability of their union will be equal to sum of their probabilities. Okay. So this is the third axiom. Third axiom can also be defined like this. For example, here we have taken N sets. In this case, we have taken N sets, okay. So, N events, okay. So, what are the an, n value is varying from 1 to so on capital N. Okay, so n may be possibly infinite also. Okay, defined on a sample space, yes. These are defined on a sample space, yes. Okay, and having the property that, what is that? AM intersection AN is equal to null set for all M is not equal to N. Means that all these are, what is this? All these are mutually exclusive. What is this statement indicates, Ma? AM intersection AN is equal to null set means what? All these events are mutually exclusive. If these, all these events are mutually exclusive, what is axiom 3 indicates? What is the probability of their union? Okay, so how many events we have? We have the events from 1 to N, no? Union of N is equal to 1 to N, AN is given as, it is given as what? It is sum of their individual probabilities. So it is sum of N is equal to 1 to N, P of AN. Okay, so this will be, this is true only if this, what is this? AM intersection AN is equal to null set. Means that all these events are mutually exclusive. Understood? Okay. So this axiom states that the probability of any event equal to union of any number of mutually exclusive events is equal to the sum of individual events probability. Okay. So it means that, see here, probability of union of any number of mutually exclusive events will be equal to what? Sum of probability of individual events. Okay, so this is the axiom number 3. Using axiom number 1, 2 and 3. Here we have defined axiom number 3 only for, by taking only 2 events, yes or no? Here, instead of 2 events, we can have infinite number of events also. You take infinite number of events, the same probability. For example, here we have 4 events, A, B, C, D. If you have 4 events, A, B, C, D, then what is the probability of A union B union C union D will be equal to what? Can you tell me, please? What, say here we have 4 events. All those 4 events are mutually exclusive. That is, A, B, C, D are mutually exclusive, then what is the probability of A union B union C union D is equal to what, ma?
Axioms and a phase fixation.
Yes, ma?
Axioms of probability and a phase fixation.
I did not understand. Mali chepamma.
Slide change kaale, ma'am.
డిస్ప్లే అవ్వట్లేదా, కనిపించట్లేదా?
నో మ్యామ్, అది ఆ స్లైడ్ అట్లానే ఉంది.
చేంజ్ అవ్వలేదు మ్యామ్, స్లైడ్ అదే స్లైడ్ ఉంది.
ఓకే, నౌ ఓకే. సో ఐ యామ్ హియర్ ఓన్లీ ఇన్ ద సేమ్ స్లైడ్. ఓకే, ఐ యామ్ ఇన్ ద సేమ్ స్లైడ్ మా యాక్చువల్లీ. ఓకే, సో నౌ ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ వి హావ్ 4 events, A, B, C, D, 4 events, then what is probability of A union B union C union D will be equal to what? Probability of A plus probability of B plus probability of C plus probability of D. Yes or no? Similarly, if you take here, you see here, this one. Now I change the slide. Can you see that? Students?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Now in this case, we have taken N number of events, and all these N events are mutually exclusive. Then what is probability of union of N mutually exclusive events will be equal to sum of probability of individual event. Okay. So these are the 3 axioms with which we will be defining what is probability. Okay. And if you have any identity, that identity will be proved with these axioms only. Okay. So any doubts till now, students? Any doubts till now? So till now we have discussed what are the different types of events, and we also discussed what are the axioms. Okay, and I will stop the meeting now. Okay, we will start the meeting again. You have to join immediately. Join immediately now. Hello, students.